What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another Pixelmon video preview. Today we're going to be checking out something pretty cool, or at least I think it's pretty cool, the Dusknoir line. And as you can see here, the Dusknoir line does include Duskull, the first evolution, Dusclops, the second evolution, and of course Dusknoir, the third evolution. So I don't know, I got to find this out, if this was made in like Maya or 3ds Max, but I'm noticing the models that are made in that program, I don't know which one it is, because there is definitely a noticeable difference. They're coming out a lot better, in my opinion at least. So as you can see right here, look at the textures and stuff though. Like, look at this guy. Obviously he is a representation of the Grim Reaper, and I found that on the Bulbapedia. I didn't come up with that myself, but you can kind of see it, and I kind of like how he only has the one eye. Definitely he has the two eye sockets and one eye in the middle, so as you transverse around him you could actually see more or less of the eye. So I think that's pretty good, and I think it was well captured in the model. Also, this is made by Joshua DA and textures by the Booty Edition. So hell yeah, booties. And inside the skull can actually be pure. Wait, inside the skull is actually pure black. Forgot to assign texture material on that. So yeah, that's as you can see right there inside the actual skull. And look at him, you can see right through him. That's actually kind of cool. I didn't realize that at first glance. So over here we do have Dusclops next, and as you can guess, Dusclops is kind of like a Cyclops. So he basically gets a full body, no longer just a skull, but still keeping that one eye. And I really like the shiny. It's like that red orange mango almost color, and I feel like it looks like a crisp nice color. The hands do look a little weird though. They kind of look like, you know, like cardboard cutout hands or something like that, and they're so straight and pointy, and all the edges and stuff. But again, that is how it is supposed to be. So there's, and yes, I am in full screen mode, so there you go. And but otherwise he kind of looks like a beehive. I mean, right? Kind of everyone else see that beehiveness? And then we do get on to the third and probably most popular evolution, Dusknoir, who I think actually, wait, did I say that right? Dusk, yeah, okay, just making four. I always forget if there's an I in between the K and Nor, but yeah, as you can see, his model is really cool, and just his model in general. I mean, look at that, this evil face on the back, or on the front, and then the more happier face on the back. Kind of looks like some weird guy, and I don't know if that's intentional, I don't know if that's what it's meant to be, but that's what it looks like to me. And he kind of just looks like a nice aggressive ghost Pokemon, which obviously this is a ghost Pokemon, but I really like it. And his shiny is actually varying from the first two, and I'm not sure if I like it more or less yet. I don't know, I like it. I just don't know if it's more or less than the other two. I kind of like that mango color at the same time, but I feel like this one, it really complements each other, the blues and stuff. I don't know how fitting that is for a ghost Pokemon, but nonetheless, very, very nice models. Definitely a good job on the texturing and the models. So if we move on to this part, oh, I'm all the way at the bottom already. And so we do have the Duskull little page here. And as I did say, Duskull is a stylized personification of the Grim Reaper. Its body is a black robe and two bones on the back. So yeah, you can see the whole kind of black robe thing. Then you see the Grim Reaper there. And I think that's pretty well captured in the model. And it looks like that, you know what I mean? So I think it came out well. In the anime, his the main appearances, you know, he's a ghost scary Pokemon, probably going to be used by Team Rocket, but at the same time he is not too strong because he is only the first evolution. And if we go down to the moves, that's the thing where it gets a little iffy. We'll get into this more at the end, but the moves, as you can see right here, he does learn Astonish pretty early on, which is kind of nice. He also does get Confused right early on, which is very, very nice, and Shadow Sneak, but otherwise nothing too crazy. He does evolve at level 37, so he has a pretty late evolution. So up until there, he does learn Will-O-Wisp right before evolution, which is a pretty good move to have, as well as Hex, but I'll get into that stuff a little bit later. So if we go back here, we are at the bottom again. We do have Dusclops, and hey, look, Tropius, we love you. And so it evolves from Duskull, obviously, and then a Dusknoir if it traded with a Reaper cloth. Hey, it looks, the first evolution looks like a Reaper, ha ha ha. So it's a roundish gray beehive body. Yeah, just insert that right there. Two stubby legs. Hey, don't call my friend stubby. Its body is hollow and can absorb much of anything, like a black hole. It has a single red eye and three tooth-like projections. So as you can see right there, yeah, they're like, I guess they're kind of teeth, but they more look like cardboard boxes that someone shoved into his body, and then they were surrounded by the beehive. It was covered in honey and then solidified. Oh, it all comes full circle. So, yeah, though, and Dusclops usually lives in thick forests. So I think this is going to be key. I think that kind of gives away where we'll find him. I think we'll find him in the same area as Ghastly and those kind of guys. So, Ghastly and Haunter. And I get the feeling you probably won't find Dusknoir in the wild. So I imagine my speculation is you'll actually get a Duskull and Dusclops spawning in the same biome as Ghastly and Haunter. And if we go down to the moveset or learn set, it's more of the same. It's just, you know, basically everything. But also at evolution, you learn Shadow Punch, which is actually going to be pretty key. That's going to be a huge, huge, you know, you want that move, in other words. So now if we go into Dusknoir, the third evolution, he traded by holding a Reaper Cloth, which, again, if you're probably just going to get a Reaper Cloth from a thing. I don't think it's in the mod yet, or in the game yet. We could check that out at the end, actually. I'll open the tab. I didn't look at that yet. So it's a black Pokemon, somewhat resembling a Cyclops. You know, obviously Dusclops resembles more of a Cyclops. And everything else is, it has an upturned collar, which is kind of cool. I did forget to mention that. It kind of looks like it has a Dracula look. But again, it has the happy face and the sad face on the back. So I thought that's my favorite part about him. Like, I don't know, maybe you could just totally see it. So there's Pokemon 7. And if we scroll all the way down, it is, again, more of the same at evolution. Well, he could evolve anytime, but it is all basically the same moves. I think it is actually literally all the same moves. And the stats are slightly increased, though, as it is with most of these guys. And I actually do like the Dusknoir model a bit more, so for that reason alone, I think it is a good reason to evolve him. So yeah, let's check this out right here. Where is it? How unprofessional is this? So the Reaper Cloth. So yeah, I don't think it is in the game yet. And it's only for Dusclops. So yeah, it is, I imagine, not in the game as, that's the episode. So there you go. Oh no, where's Smogon? Oh no, I just skipped over Smogon. Okay, there you go. So yeah, here we do have Dusknoir on Smogon, and he sucks. There's no if, whats, or bad. Gengar beats him in every department, and his stats are his main, you know, hurtness. Ghost Pokemon have special attacking moves, and as we saw the moves before, all of the ghost moves were special attacking. His special attack is in the gutter. It is crap. I mean, ghost Pokemon don't have good attacking moves like that, yeah, or in dark Pokemon also, and so Shadow Ball and, you know, Nightshade, stuff like that, you're not gonna really get that much use out of them on him, because it's just, he has a super high attack, well, not a super high, but he has a good attack, but the only real move that's gonna benefit from that, and his stab, is going to be, Sucker Punch. So when he evolves into Dusclops, he'll get Sucker Punch, which is going to definitely increase his damage output by a ton. It's going to be really helpful for you, but otherwise you can't really use his typing to your advantage that much. There's not going to be anything here. I mean, again, as you can see with the learn set, Will-O-Wisp, Pain Split, which is kind of hard to get in Pixelmon. Fire Punch and Earthquake are going to all be kind of useful, but at the same time, he's going to be a cool Pokemon to be added, but I don't see him being used too competitively, because he, again, kind of sucks, and his stats just don't complement.